As you can clearly see with the head off, all 16 valves were bent. This is all from a timing chain that jumped or collapsed.
Welcome back to Bennett's Garage. Today we are working on a 2011 Buick LaCrosse 2.4 liter. It's either jump timing or timing chain snapped. We might have bent valves in it. We don't know yet. We won't know until we get into it. So first thing you got to do, take your cover off. You got to take your coil packs out, your spark plugs out. Like to get your intake off, the intake pipe hose.
Right here, I'm just gonna fast forward a few. We're just trying to take the intake off, take the valve cover off. And once we get this valve cover off, you'll definitely see the carnage that is inside. We really didn't expect it until we started taking out the VVT solenoids. Once we pulled the VVT solenoids out, we noticed there was a lot of plastic or metal shavings inside of the engine. So that kind of gave us an idea of what's going on in there. So once we pull out these VVTs, you'll see for yourself how bad it is. And then once we pull off the cover, you'll see everything is just gone to crap.
Thank you.
Yeah.
There we go. Oh, look at the chunkiness on there. Oh, we got issues.
Yep.
That's metal. Oh, yeah. We're gonna have some pretty nasty internal damage here. Well, that's not good, guys. That's not good at all. I expect to see some pretty nasty damage in here.
So at this point, as you can see with the VVT solenoids that we pulled out, that we have a lot of glitter, a lot of, I'm not even sure if it's plastic or metal shavings in this thing. So we're just taking off the valve cover. There's a hose that has to come off that it actually comes off fairly easy. There's a 13 millimeter on the side of the head that holds on this other little brick thing. Once you take that off, the front hose comes right off. So once we start cracking open this valve cover, we're going to be able to see the actual chain inside. So the chain has not snapped. But once we took off the bottom timing chain cover and noticed what's going on down there, we noticed that the valve guides did give way. The tensioner did give way. There's a nice piece of chunky metal that's wrapped around the actual crankshaft pulley. It gave way. So we know that we're going to be taking the head off this thing and trying to figure out what to do next. How far the customer wants to go with it. Does she want a new engine to put in? Does she want us just to repair this one and then go from there? I have a funny feeling this lady is just going to want everything to be completely fixed. She wants her car back. The car's in immaculate condition. It's 200,000 miles. So once we call the customer, that's what I think she's going to do. So, and you'll find out later what she actually chose to do.
Bolt right there.
No. You forgot a bolt.
Got a bolt, but yeah, they came up that far.
Yeah, it wasn't tight.
Here's a magnet. moment of truth.
Yes, sir.
I see a chain.
Yep.
You have the attention.
Actually, it doesn't look that bad. Oh.
Shit.
Yep. All of them are that way.
Every single one.
It's dead.
Yeah, this motor's dead.
So.
Oh my gosh.
Yep, it jumped time.
Well. Technically, with all of that off, let's blow air into them. If it holds, we can always rebuild.
Yeah.
If it doesn't hold, we're looking for a new motor.
Nope.
But look at the plastic up here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You want to go get my compression tester?
Where is it?
Oh, it's... Yeah.
Unless the...
I think the cam's wiped.
After inspecting the cams really good, this head is toast. We are going to be doing a head gasket now instead of a timing set. So, head gasket, timing set. I'm still going to blow air into it to see if it holds, but I have zero hopes right now that anything holds at all. Right there's the air. Now for those of you who wonder if you have a bent valve or not, you can see all these are out. There's nothing holding these valves open. And go ahead. So, very clearly, like a megaphone, shooting right out of that. Yeah, pull it back a little bit. So, every one of your intake valves are busted. Back on this thing, and the customer said go ahead and do whatever it takes to get it back on the road again. And the cam is definitely wiped. You see, it's wiped there. Back here, you have it. It's wiped on that one. So, both intake cam and exhaust cam are shot. The cams are $129 each. Each one of these is $26.50 each, $29.95 each, something like that. And you can see they're bad. Then as we're going through it, this crazy chunk of metal popped out of somewhere. I have no idea where it came from. So basically, when your timing chain goes bad on these 2.4s, it's going to wipe out your valves, and it did on this one. This line here is just easier to unplug it, and it just pulls up to get this line out of the way. That's really stuck into these down here, so just pull it up, pop these things out like that. He's going to take off the upper radiator hose next. Just trying to get everything that we need out of the way in order to get this intake off. Yeah, the hose is going to be front and back side. Completely remove it.
I'm going to start and take this whole thing up out of the way to get access.
Was it 10 mil?
10 mil bolts. Well, this thing right here just takes this damn bracket off.
You can't cuss.
I get demonetized.
We also gotta take the wiring loom off here and here.
Yep.
Unless that's the whole bracket that holds that. There's another one.
Paper clip.
Get a screwdriver on the bottom of it. I see it right here.
Out of the way.
Not spreading out. Once you get the everything de-loomed, de-wired, you're gonna have 13 millimeter bolts. All we did was pull this thing back. It's useless. Take off your 13 millimeter bolts. Take off your intake. Something's holding it. There we go. Let me guess. Dial pins. And this thing is gonna have to come off anyway, or a twist.
And it won't twist because of that line.
Might be enough.
This wiring that you're holding.
Oh, it's the wiring holding it. The dipstick bracket or something? You need to take the dipstick out? You already drained the oil, right?
Yep. Got the clip undone, and you just spin it around and work it up out of there.
Now you can see why the intake wouldn't come off. Okay. Now out to AC line. There's still more wires attached to it. Well, the friggin' apron goes all the way down, doesn't it? Alright, there's the intake. And we're just gonna take this apron off, put it right back in our parts washer. See if we see any of the valves that are open. Holy crap, did they look terrible. Oh yeah, every single one. I don't know. Let's see if I can get the light in there. Just the right angle. You can actually see the valves open. All the way open. There we go. You can see completely in the head. So. Yep. Ain't no doubt about it. It's coming off.
It does not have to come off. It is right below the head. So okay. It'll be out of the way.
And the direct fuel injection, we might have to take it off to take it to the machine shop, but we don't have to take it off now just to take the head off the bottom end. Now we just start working on the exhaust side. We gotta take the heat shield off and then get to the exhaust bolts.
There's a cover that goes over top of the manifold right here. There's 3 10 mil bolts. Pull them out. The cover comes right up off. Then you got, I've done pulled 4 of them off, but there's half inch or 13 mil. A good, I pulled 4 of them off so far. I think there's 8 or 9 that holds the exhaust on.
So you have top row and the bottom row?
Yep.
Okay. So you're just getting off the top row. And the other side that came off is. Like that? No. Anyways, this door pieces of it missing.
Yeah.
We're probably gonna have to drop the oil pan, and that's not gonna be fun either. I bet you there's another bolt up there holding it at the top side.
Well, it's moving.
This is supposed to be right up here on the top of this.
Chain smacked it so much that it just broke it off and it got wedged down on the bottom timing gear.
So the plastic's missing, the metal's missing, it ate through everything. Nice and sharp. And the other part on the bottom, missing plastic down here, and compare. So yeah, we had some carnage.
So he does anything.
It's out. That's awesome.
Thought it was.
Well, I guess we're gonna have to get a screwdriver or something in there. It has to come off. The cam has to come off. All right, let's take the cam.
Yep,
it is. It just stuck in there.
Holy heck. Okay. Did we ruin the gasket?
Nope.
Okay. The kit I bought might have came with a new one. I don't know. Now we can take the cams off. They're trash. But we do have to save the bearings. Cam bearings.
Should we take this off too?
Yeah, probably.
Probably, because it'll...
Yeah.
That's what that one bolt right there is for.
And we take the cam caps off. We're going to have to put them in order on a piece of cardboard or something.
Yep.
They have to go on in the exact same order. Do the bearings look good? They actually do.
Yeah.
So the head is salvageable.
Mm-hmm.
We have to take everything out of the head, but the head itself is salvageable.
Yep.
Okay. How bad is the cam?
Grooves down them.
Any groove at all means it's toasted, so. I already bought new ones.
We're taking the head off. This is the torque spec, which ones you go to.
So this is putting it back on. So yep. You're going to start in the middle putting it back on. However, when you're taking it off.
We started at number 10, then went to 9, 8, 7, all the way down to 1.
Okay, so that's what we did here. And you did it?
Half a turn. Backed each of them off half a turn. Went all the way around them. Backed them off another half a turn.
Until they got loose.
Yep.
Yeah. And that's where we are now. Yep. We're about to take them completely out.
Nice.
Then once we take them completely out, we were not able to get the back header manifold off the engine.
It might be able to stay right there where it's at.
So we're going to try to make it stay and pull the engine up. Or pull the head up without the manifold on. We won't know until we get this completely out. At this point, if you want to use a gun, you can, because
yeah.
there's nothing tight there.
He's getting it.
There are going to be some long ass head bolts. Yep.
Yeah.
And they do have Loctite on them. Is this bracket held to anything?
No.
Okay. I know it's a pulling. I actually pulled the head. I saw you pull straight up. It's already loose. No, that's the engine.
Yep, that's the whole motor.
Okay, is there anything else holding the two together?
The Torx.
Okay.
Inverted Torx.
Inverted torque going straight down.
Yep.
There it is. Way down there in the corner.
E12.
E12, okay.
Yep.
these are.
Probably antifreeze.
Everything leaking?
Probably.
Oh, that's fine. These are the bolts that came out.
All the valves.
Yep.
Okay, so there's the piece you're missing.
Yep.
Looks fine to me.
Alrighty, now that we're putting the oil pan back on, we decided, you know, we should take that off because, you know, we've been finding bits and pieces of everything laying around this thing, the full destruction. And this is all, yeah, from the oil pan. And you might say, okay, what about the pickup tube? All of that was in the pickup tube. So, yes, it needs the oil pan cleaned. Yes, you gotta go through it. It's a disaster once this does happen to you.